More breaking updates coming in. The latest with regards to the Bengaluru violence case probe. The National Investigation Agency has taken over the investigation of the Bengaluru violence case. Remember, two areas of Bengaluru, DJ Halli and KG Halli, had witnessed widespread violence on August 11th after a mob went on a rampage. The NIA will probe the case now. So that's a big development there coming in this case. Let me bring in my colleague Neha Hebale for all the updates coming in. Neha, big development coming in the Bengaluru violence case. Now the NIA would be probing the latest in this. So far, what has been the kind of investigation that has happened in this case?
Well, Apoorva, yes, in fact, this was after an MHA order now that the NIA has decided to probe two of the many FIRs that have been registered in the Bengaluru violence case. Let's just remind you that, you know, these two cases that the NIA is probing have sections of the UAPA, which is precisely why the NIA has now gotten involved. But Apoorva, you know, even as we are talking about the investigation, it is imperative to remember that, you know, what really happened on August 11th and why exactly, you know, now you have the NIA probing this. August 11th, you know, you had a mob of at least a good 1,000 people that attacked two police stations in Bengaluru and also a Congress leader's house after a reportedly controversial post, you know, about Muhammad, Prophet Muhammad went viral, following which a large mob gathered. They pelted stones, sticks, they burnt down two police stations, they burnt down the house of the Congress leader, Akhand Srinivas Murthy as well, following which, you know, of course, multiple cases were registered. Nearly about 350 people were arrested. 65 plus FIRs that were registered, and of these, the two FIRs where the UAPA Act, you know, where the UAPA in fact has been invoked, is now where the NIA will be investigating.
All right, Neha, many thanks for joining us and getting us all those details.